Hello, my name is Jennifer Vasquez Perez, and I'm a pediatric pharmacist here at Orlando Health Arnold Palmer Hospital for Children. I'm going to talk to you today about a medication taken by mouth called prednisone or prednisolone, which is a type of corticosteroid. This medication is used for many different conditions such as asthma, skin rashes, or swelling. When being used in the setting of asthma, this medication is needed for a flare-up that might have been caused by a trigger or maybe a viral infection that has led to the worsening of asthma. The inflammation in the airways might be so strong that patients are unable to get enough control with just inhalers alone, and they need to take an oral steroid medicine to gain control. We call this a short course or a steroid burst. Prednisone and prednisolone work by lowering the amount of inflammation in the body. This is how it is helpful in the treatment of different inflammatory conditions. When your child takes this medication at home, give them the medication exactly as prescribed by your doctor or as directed on your discharge instructions. This medication is commonly taken by mouth one or two times per day. If your child misses a dose, give it as soon as you remember. If it is almost time for your child's next dose, give only that dose. Do not give double or extra doses. Prednisolone is usually given as a liquid solution, and prednisone is usually given as a tablet. If your child is taking the prednisone tablet, they should swallow the tablet whole with a full glass of water. If your child is taking the prednisolone liquid, shake well and make sure to pull up the prescribed dose of the medication using an oral syringe. Remember to measure the dose by lining up the top of the outer black line of the plunger with the desired dose or number on the syringe. The straight edge of the plunger is used to measure the medicine. Do not measure at the dome. Also, do not use a household teaspoon or tablespoon, as these are not accurate measuring devices for medication administration. It is best to take the medication with food or milk. If your child will be taking this medication for a prolonged period of time, such as greater than 2 or 3 weeks, the medical team may slowly lower the dose of the medication to avoid abruptly stopping. If this is the case, talk with your pharmacist about the specific taper schedule that was prescribed for your child. Side effects your child might have with this medication include increased appetite, puffiness, moodiness, or behavior changes, trouble sleeping, headache, or feeling tired or weak. Another side effect is upset stomach, but taking the medication with food can help prevent that. If your child experiences severe stomach pain, nausea, vomiting blood, or red or black stools as a side effect of this medication, make sure to seek medical attention right away. Other rare but serious side effects requiring medical attention right away include signs of an allergic reaction, such as hives, swelling, or trouble breathing, signs of an infection, including fever or chills, and signs of very high blood pressure, such as a bad headache or dizziness, passing out, or changes in eyesight. When you get home, keep the medication in a dry place away from heat or moisture, and away from small children. The prednisone tablet can be stored at room temperature. Some brands of the prednisolone liquid need to be stored in a refrigerator, so ask your pharmacist about storage if your child will be taking prednisolone liquid at home. Make sure to listen closely to the instructions described by your doctor to know if your child needs to return to the emergency room. And please let your nurse, doctor, or pharmacist know if you have any questions at all about this medication. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.